Welcome, children. So today I am taking class, third day class for you. This is the third day I am taking. And yesterday, first day we finished page number 19 and 20. And next day, 21 and 22 are finished. Now let me tell you. Now here, I told you to write your family, draw your family tree. Or you can write the generations, how much generations you are having in your home, so that it will tell you about your family. So also I told you to write how many generations are there in your family. You can write here how many answers, three questions are asked here. You can write how many generations are there in your family. In my family, means in Manu's Manu's family, there are four generations. How many generations are there in my family? In Manu's family, four generations. Then how many generations are there in your family? You can write here. You can draw or write them. Which is the bigger family of the two families? You can write it also. Whether yours or Manu's. So here, already told you whether your family is a nuclear family, that is small family or joint family, you can identify by putting right mark here, right or wrong mark here. So you can do this one. I told you already how to do it. Next, page number 24 today, and I showed you the picture of a joint family here, this one. So also some conditions are given here while writing the your generations here. So you can read them and write them now. So let me tell you once again, page number 24. So do you know this? While preparing family tree, the names of children are written according to the seniority. Keep in mind that when you are writing the family tree or the generations, you must write the name of children according to the seniority. You should have from elder brothers to younger brother, or elder sisters to younger sister, like that seniority. And the family tree, the names of children of that family from eldest to youngest is first written, and then the names of husband, wife are written. Also, you must write the names of children of the family, eldest to youngest, small from youngest to youngest, eldest to youngest you must write, and then names of the husband and wife should be written. The word family tree indicates that many generations spread out and grow like the branches of the tree, but while drawing a family tree, it is written from the eldest to youngest, from top to bottom, So just like branches of the tree, your generation also must indicates the family tree indicates that how many generations spread out, just like the branches of the tree. So it is written this way, that to denote the younger generation from the older generations, after the older generation. First you must start with your eldest generation to younger generation. Now here some of the activities are given here, page number 25. Look here, write the similarities and differences you have noticed so far among my, your, and my family, friends' families. So what you are going to do is write the similarities with same characters, and differences means what are different things you have noticed so far among my family, means mother's family, and your family, means you, and your friends' families. All things you are going to write here. So let us start page number 25. Family day 3. So first activity 1, you can write here. The test book only you can show it. Activity 1. So similarity. Similarity means what are same things? Similarities. Same things you see here. What same things you see in all the three families? Your family, mother's family and friend's family, what similarity you see and what all differences you see. Differences you observe should be expected. So be careful. Similarities and differences you are observing here. So in all of these families, education is given. All that they give education, give education. All the people they give education. It is first one, give education. And secondly, but all differences. Sometimes some people don't give importance to the some people don't give importance. Don't give importance to education. So this is the differences you may observe. Asuka. Now the second one. Some people in the show love and affection. Show love and affection. But here, don't like each other. And people also say, don't like each other. Don't like each other. Thirdly, provide necessities. NECWS. Provide necessary things. Maybe may provide. Provide necessities. NECWSIT. Provide necessities. Sometimes not possible to provide. Sometimes some people. Or some people do not provide necessities required things. Understood? A fourth, take care and protect. Some people take care and protect. But in some families, don't take care of others. Others means in family member only. Family members only don't take the care of others. So these are the four
advantages and disadvantages of this family. So if
you are having a joint family, so you can write, if your friend is having joint family, you can write what are the different advantages or disadvantages among the
family and right here. So try to write here what are the, how it is useful and how it is not done. Now second one, activity 2, activity 2, advantages of joint family, right here. Advantages of joint family, disadvantages, of joint family. Let us see what are the advantages and what are the disadvantages. Advantages and disadvantages. First one, family members help each other. With joint family, what happens? Family members help each other. Disadvantages. Then what are the disadvantages? But sometimes disadvantage may be cannot get help because all are busy. Second, all family members
was sent to the war together. All members can do the work. But some members do not work. Do not work. All members can do the work. This will make all some members do not work. Get support from elders, and elders. Get support from elders and elders. All people, we can get support. Some of them do not like to support. Get together this by living in such family. People get that. They feel togetherness. It's living together, it is one of the very, we think it is very, it is all together living, it is one of the attractive, but some people become lazy here. Some people, they feel together this. Some people become lazy. Some people become lazy. These are the four differences. Advantages and disadvantages are given here. So then family members help each other, and here disadvantages cannot get help because all are busy. All family members can do the work, some members do not work, like to work. Get support from elders and elders. Some of them do not like to support. They feel togetherness, and some people will become lazy while living in the joint family. So these are the advantages and disadvantages I give you. Remaining things are remaining things I'll continue next video. So you can write these two things in your classroom. So let me continue page number 26, question 28 next video. Read two, you can write them, or if you are having any other things of disadvantages or advantages, you can write your own. So some are given here, you can copy down. Thank you.